No AI was used in the creation of this video or the selection of these features. This is all out of my human brain. However, we are going to be talking a lot about AI in the Wave 1 2023 release, particularly when it comes to Dynamics 365 sales. We've got AI coming all over the sales process. This is going to be a really interesting year, so let's crack in and see what you've got to look forward to. These are the 10 features that I think are the most important across the customer engagement apps, sales, marketing, and customer service. And I'm going to spend a fair bit of time here talking about the sales app because honestly, game-changing stuff for the year. So what we've got first is the ability to use SMS conversation chat back and forth with your customer from the sales app. I apologize for the quality of this screenshot. It's not you, it's not YouTube, it's definitely not me. When Microsoft do these release notes, they sometimes give us screenshots, but they're tiny files and I zoom in and it's really hard to see. But anyway, I'd rather give you this than nothing. So just, you know, roll with it. On the right-hand side there, Regina Murphy, that is a chat that's going back and forth between the salesperson and the customer by SMS. So the experience for the seller is that you'll get real-time notifications in the app and you will be able to interact by chat in that side panel. For the administrator, they'll be able to set up people with the right numbers and so on to use, and you'll be able to do that conversation in SMS. Now, I did say we're going to talk a fair bit about AI, and I've got a few features here that we're going to run through that are all about how AI can assist the sales process. And this is all part of what was formerly known as the Sales Accelerator. Language is changing. It's now called Sales Enablement. And I think we're going to see some, you know, got to love some language change as part of a new release. But the core part of this that we're going to be looking at is this Up Next widget. Now, I didn't put a number on this feature, but I've snuck an extra one in because, come on, you must expect that from me by now. This is an enhanced version of that Up Next widget. So we've had this for a little while. It will tell the seller what to work on next based on something that's come out of a predetermined sequence of activities or based on something that you've put in manually as the seller. But now we bring AI into the picture. So first up, we have that enhancement to that widget. And then these features as we go through are all, well, in fact, not all, many of the different ways that this is happening. And there's a lot going on here. I've picked out the ones that I think are the most important. Cross-sell and upsell suggestions. So this is an AI-based feature that goes through your historically successful deals and proposes products with upsell and cross-sell opportunities to help you sell more. So we've got an example here of upsell of premium license, and you can see there in that Up Next widget that the seller can choose to accept or reject that. We also have the ability to provide tips and suggestions. So while the seller is on a customer call, it is using conversation intelligence to automatically surface real-time suggestions and tips. Here's an example here in the black at the bottom there. Contoso was mentioned. Contoso is a good investment opportunity. So as the seller is working through, they're getting prompted with those suggestions. What do you think of this stuff? Let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to give this video a like if you're finding it useful. Improve seller effectiveness. This is around saying, well, you might have a high volume of accounts, like hundreds of accounts that you're working on, and which one should you work on next? So we've already got this idea of an intelligent work list. This is starting to bring AI suggestions there to have a curated list of targeting the prioritized accounts, which ones you should work on next. So making that whole thing more efficient in those high volume, low touch scenarios. This one I really like. This is starting to get into really clever use of the conversation intelligence that's going on. So this is about being able to capture and make sure you've captured crucial details of a sales call. We've got an acronym here, BANT, you may or may not be familiar with, which is budget, authority, need, and timeline. And so what this is doing is as the seller is working through the call, it's checking, have they got all of those things? So there is classification for detected questions. Did they ask about those things? Call notes that are oriented around those critical things, grouping of mentions around the role of the person. If someone says, oh yes, I'm the director, or someone else is the finance officer, or whatever it is, and then topics for playback. This is going to be real cool to play with. Stay tuned. I'm definitely going to do a video on this once I can get my hands on that. And finally, in this section here, we have automated follow-up tasks. I don't know about you, I'm not great at remembering to create the follow-up tasks, so this is going to be using an automatic way of doing that, and the beauty here is it's going across all of your different things. So of course we've got Dynamics, Teams, Outlook and so on, all on the same platform because Microsoft. So follow-up tasks will be automatically created based on emails, Teams messages and calls. This one will be really amazing. Moving along now to Dynamics Marketing. Now, fully connected system here. Remember, we're talking about sales sequences there. The marketing application will soon be able to push from marketing journey through into a sales sequence. So I'm kind of doing it the other way around today, but don't forget those things are connected in that way. But two really critical features here in the marketing application. One of them is the automatic UTM tagging. Now, if you're working with marketing, you'll go, hooray, this is something we've wanted for a long time. UTM tagging is around being able to track with codes the traffic. So if you're sending out emails and people are clicking through to the website, you want to be able to see where that traffic is coming from and to be able to measure it. So that's something we are going to be able to automatically generate in Dynamics Marketing this year. And the other one, which has actually been on my wish list, I did actually, was one of the, I'm sure many people who suggested this one, a frequency cap to prevent message fatigue. So if you're sending out lots of different emails and messages and things, then you want to be able to prioritize and say, do you know what, don't send any individual person more than three messages in a week, excluding those transactional messages like receipts and so on. So that is something we're going to be able to do as well. And finally here we have customer service. I have actually got something in here that goes back across the whole platform, so make sure you are paying attention. Firstly, on the AI side, it's all about nuance. There's quite a lot of features coming through here. So Nuance is a Microsoft acquisition that has a heap of AI, again, things that really, really high-end ability to do security on voice recognition and understand what's going on in a conversation. So AI suggested replies we've got coming on here, real-time suggested replies for agents in that scenario. So you can see here the agent is being given some very specific suggestions about how to respond to this. And here's a big one at number 10, and it's, I've saved it till the end here, a new email template designer. Now this sits in the customer service app, but you can use this anywhere. You can use this back in the sales app as well, and check it out. Look, it looks like the marketing designer. So I'm going to be able to, I think, do some properly beautiful emails out of the customer engagement side of things now without necessarily needing marketing to do beautiful emails. And one final thing before you go, early access January 2023, make sure you're subscribed. I'm going to be doing a video towards the end of January once I've got these things. There's a handful of features out of the sales app that we're getting at the end of January, and this is my hottest pick. This is the new opportunity pipeline view. I've talked about this one before, but I will be bringing you a video on this as soon as I can. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching, as always.